Welcome back to NC Sports Weekly News. As more powerful stories fill the lineup, three oceans for a hat trick, France's Emmanuel Coindre rewrites the history of the discipline. Sébastien Destremaux reports on the TP52 Super Series season kickoff and the record quest drama on the Maxi Multihulls. Asia goes a center stage, first at the Royal Langkawi Regatta in Malaysia, and then at the KTA Bintan, next stop, kilometer 52. This is the place. NC Sports, plunge into the action. Crowning a historic hat-trick along the three oceans, French rower Emmanuel Coindre enters the realm of legend and writes a whole new page in nautical sports history. He has already done the Atlantic five times and once the North Pacific. Now in 57 days, he has also completed the 3,500-mile crossing of the Indian Ocean from Australia to the island of La Réunion, just east of Madagascar. One person rowing alone and without assistance against the three oceans. It had never been done before. The French 39-year-old rode 18 hours per day to reach his goal and allowed just 2-3 hours for sleep. Compared to his past experiences, the Indian Ocean offered new and different challenges, such as the absence of any favorable surf, which made it a very demanding effort, and the scorching heat when navigating just 20 degrees south of the equator. With two capsizes, tricky redressing maneuvers in the high seas, water in the boat, and dead batteries, Coindre had to manage even without most electronics and navigation systems. Fortunately, the old compass, the satellite tracker, and the sat phones on board still worked, allowing the shore team to keep in touch and guide him on the right path to Port West. Deliberately starting off in late November to hook up with the cyclone season, the extreme navigator and his long course met up with the fury of several systems, like the awesome and violent Bruce, and then again with the angry Colin, which reportedly shoved them along to a swift final passage. Emmanuel had gone in survival mode early on following his day two capsize, and admittedly rode it to save his skin.
Welcome to the office. The first stage of the 52 Super Series Americans show gets underway in Key West, Florida. Compared to the current America's Cup boat, one can argue that these monohulls look a bit has-been. But how can we not be enthusiastic about these super high-tech machines? This class is the most exclusive category on the planet when it comes down to technology. And when you're called quantum racing, you even use the services of your own drone before each race to provide extremely precise information. Accuracy and precision are paramount to properly sail these yachts. Clumsiness is not an option. During Key West, quantum racing shows what they are made of when they take the first three races win. A showdown with a powerful Azzurra team is not happening, and it is Ran who manages to get second place. The perfect conditions, with wind blowing over 20 knots, allowed Doug DeVos's crew to consolidate his leadership on the last day. With 5 wins out of 10 races held, Quantum Racing and Air Drone win the first stage of the 52 Super Series.
Feels wonderful. I love this place. So we've been sailing here for so many years, and a lot of years we weren't even close to the leaderboard, you know. But we just love the event. We love the location. Great sailing conditions, so it feels great to be able to come back here sailing with everybody and do well.
The fleet will gather in Miami in early March before returning to Europe for spring. In the family of the record hunters, one is laughing, another clinches his teeth, and the third is sobbing. Enjoying a perfect weather window, Banque Populaire leaves Cadix in the evening of January 23rd to launch an assault on the Atlantic crossing record. Although the conditions are tough, the Maltese is sailing an almost straight line across the Atlantic towards the Bahamas. Hitting top speed in excess of 35 knots, Armel Le Cleac'h is pedal to the metal.
We're starting with a new 24-hour record. Between yesterday and tonight, we covered a 682 nautical mile. Credit must go to the boat and the whole team who prepared her so well.
Checking on Sodebo's position on the map as she's traveling along the coast of Brazil, one might say that Thomas is enjoying a coffee break.
The boat is going straight, the sea is completely flat, and we've still got 18 knots of wind to be exact. The boat is sailing at speeds between 27 and 32 knots. It's really nice sailing, and the temperature is ideal. It's pitch dark and you can't see a thing.
Although the sailing conditions are fantastic, Sodebo is falling behind the record time established by Francis Joyon. The bleeding will continue as Sodebo has a gigantic St. Helen high to deal with. The weather situation is quite complex and Thomas has no choice but to sit tight and wait. But for now, he just enjoys the moment. Monday, at precisely 3:57 p.m., the skipper of the maxi trimaran Princess de Bretagne, Lionel Lemonchoix, manually triggers his distress beacon. Contacted by satellite phone a few hours later, Lionel tells his team that the trimaran had capsized. He was sound and safe inside the boat's central hull, but was forced to cut her rigging. The maxi trimaran Prince de Bretagne left Brittany on Friday, January 17, to tackle the Mauritian's record held since 2009 by Francis Joyon. When the beacon was triggered, the trimaran was approximately 800 nautical miles off the Brazilian coast at the latitude of Rio de Janeiro, sailing upwind in a breeze between 16 and 18 knots. Rendezvous next week, same time, same place. Until then, goodbye and fair sailing.
The sailing epicenter has definitely moved to Asia as more classics dot the winter calendar in the Northern Hemisphere. Now celebrating 12 years on the circuit, the Royal Langkawi International Regatta kicked off to a bang in strong wind conditions along its senior courses, putting to the test over 350 sailors on 44 yachts from 16 countries. Under the auspices of the Malaysian Yachting Association and ISAF, the regatta is part of the Asian Yachting Circuit and officially raises the curtain on the Visit Malaysia Year 2014 national campaign. Entries opened to 8 sailing classes, racing, IRC-1, IRC-2, sports boat, multi-hull white sails, ocean rover and club cruising. During the week-long event, plenty of attention went to the super yacht fleet with Yelik, skippered by Frank Pong, and Lero 3 with Alexei Takovsky, Asian Yachting Circuit's skipper of 2013, as they battle it out against the top entries like Foxy Lady, Fortissimo, Phoenix, Andaman Cabriolinina, and Mystery. While Malaysian sailing teams put their own armada on the water with Utarid, Uranus, Matahari, Evelyn, and Shantique. In the end, it would be up to Bill Bremer's Foxy Lady 6 of Singapore to take home the Lada IRC Challenge Trophy. The return of Aussie skipper Peter Ahern to the race after 8 years was the talk of the town, especially since he came to win his fourth Prime Minister's Challenge Trophy in the racing division on his yacht, Oil. In other results, Daniel Reno's afterburner of Thailand walked away with the Malaysian Multi-Hull Challenge Cup, and Yacht Elena, skippered by Vyacheslav Somov, took home the RYLC Commodore's Challenge Cup in the club class. More water sports action happening in Asia as the Kite Tour Asia 2014 moved on to Bintan, Indonesia, in the turquoise waters of the South China Sea. Tough conditions marked the first 2 days of competition, with 25 knot wind gusts pushing up a huge swell that washed over the reef at Trikora Beach, also known as Kilometer 52. Narapachit Yo Pudla, Thailand, a reigning KTA race board champion, had no rivals, if not in Swiss rider Astrid Bertz, 41, who also scored 6 bullets in the mixed men and women's scoreboard, beating most of the guys and securing a leadership spot. Wind drops instead caused a few upsets in the twin-tip competition, now recognized as class by the International Sailing Federation, ISAF, and was also a chance to tally valuable points for the International Kiteboarding Association, IKA World Ranking. Louis Bonga Fernando from the Philippines used his light wind superiority on arch-rivals Pudla and compatriot Doke de los Santos. Ukrainian Lisa Nikitina, who had appeared to struggle slightly in the heavier airs, then recovered on the light winds, setting back Germany's Catherine Borgwart, and closed with a stellar victory in overall. It was a battle of the teenagers in the men's freestyle, as a Slovenian Jaka Komolkar, 17, faced off in a super final with 18-year-old Dylan van der Meeg from the Netherlands. Putting on their best S-bend passes, blind judge threes, and back mobs, both competitors showed equal power and flow, forcing the judges to a much-delayed decision in favor of van der Meeg. In women's freestyle, Estefania Rosa Santos first did away with British champion Rosanna Jury, who took a hard crash in shallow water. The Brazilian then took out day one winner Kelly Shouten, as both athletes struggled to play tricks in the 7-minute final with 25 knot winds and a rolling swell. Santos ultimately sealed her Bintan victory with a super series of spectacular tricks, including a blind judge 3, a slim chance, and a shifty 3. Don't miss the full inside take on the TP52 Super Series 2014 season kickoff in Key West. It's all coming up in the next edition of Buzz. Plunge into the action with NC Sports.